You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
For the community, by the community.
Get ready to find hope. Get ready to be inspired. Get ready to discover your full potential. Get ready for total success. From the Total Success Coach, Princess Bola Adelani.
Adelani, the Total Success Coach, welcoming you to Inspired Success, your monthly dose of inspiration power, the program that equips you with the power and inspiration for total success. That is success at work and in life. It's February already. It's February 2011. It just seems like yesterday when we were saying, wishing each other Happy New Year. How time flies. You know, I was thinking about that. Time really does fly. It seems that this planet is really revolving, you know, at jet speed. And, you know, food for thought. This is food for thought. This is not what we're going to be talking about today. But food for thought is just do it. Whatever it is that you plan to do, whatever it is you desire to do, now is the time to do it. You know, time isn't waiting for you. So, Mr. or Miss Procrastinator, you get going and get doing. Anyway, I welcome you to Inspire Success. I welcome you again to the month of February, the month of love. And on the Inspire Success this month, you know, we're continuing with what we started in January, which is building the power bridges to our destiny. You know, I'm going to be sharing with you on Inspire Success for the next couple of months the principles, the power bridges that you really must be building to that will take you from point A to point Z. It will take you from A to Z in this year 2011. And if you recall, last month we talked about building the money bridge, okay? For those viewers who missed the show last month, don't forget that you can go on whctv.org or my website, royalproclamations.com, and view the videos on demand. The video on demand is there on the internet. So at your convenience, you can, you know, watch and review past broadcasts and really get that information, you know, down where you really need it on your fingertips. So last month, we began with laying the money bridge, which we talked about, money power bridge. And it was very interesting. I had a great guest on the show. But this month, the month of love, it's about people. We're building the people bridge, the connection bridge. The connection bridge, because, you know, we need people. Dreams are not solitary. You know, dreams are not solitary. You cannot, you know, self-exist. You know, you can't achieve success or your dreams or anything by yourself. So we're going to be talking about building the people bridge. Building the people bridge on this show today. Very, 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 very important subject. And we're also going to be talking about networking as a tool and as a strategy for building those bridges and for getting ahead for business and for love. Okay, so it's a really very interesting subject because after all, this is the month of love. So, you know, we just have to bring it in and see how our networking does and help to enhance our people connections for business and for love. And I have with me, honestly, on the studio today, you know already that I'm the queen of networking, but I have a colleague of mine who's a networking guru. She's an author. She's a national speaker. She's an executive presentation coach. She's America's marketing motivator. And I have the pleasure of welcoming Kathy McAfee onto inspired success to date.
Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here.
It's really great to have you on the show. And may I add that Kathy is also the author of the new book, Networking Ahead for Business. Networking Ahead for Business. Phenomenal book that we're going to be referring to throughout the broadcast today. So once again, it's really great to have you, Kathy. Kathy is also going to be our featured presenter at the Total Woman Conference, mm-hmm. Which is coming up on April 2nd at the Simsbury Inn in Simsbury, mm-hmm. Connecticut. So, you know, if you want to meet Kathy live, you know, which I know you'd really, really want to after you've heard her speak today on the show, just save the date. Make sure you register for the Total Woman Conference on April 2nd. Early registration has really begun already this month of February, so take advantage of that and register at totalwomanconference.com. So it's great to have you here. Honestly, I'm really thrilled that you're here today and you'll be sharing with me and participating in this discussion about building our people connections, you know, building those people connections. Mm-hmm. And I want us to start right away, just dive into the conversation and begin by, you know, sharing how important really people are generally to our success.
Princess Bola, I can't think of anything that I've accomplished in my life that didn't involve other people. Mm. Now, I'm a huge self-starter, I'm very driven, but people, college professors, parents, neighbors, colleagues, associates, they've all been part of creating that success.
Absolutely.
In fact, I will share with you, even the accomplishment of publishing a book.
Yes.
I could not have done this without a whole bunch of people, including you, who so graciously reviewed the manuscript and provided a testimonial for the back. So even something like this, you think, wow, she's written a book. It would not have happened if it wasn't for those power bridges of people.
Exactly, exactly. I mean, that is it. You know, I often say this. I say no one is self-existing. Only God is self-existing. You know, we're social beings. We're interdependent mm-hmm. on each other. You know, and a success takes a synergy of resources, of information, mm-hmm. of skills, of talents. You know, for it to happen. Mm-hmm. So no matter how talented you are, you do need someone's help and assistance or information mm-hmm. or skill set to help you to achieve, you know, your goals and your dreams. So that is how valuable people are. And I really want viewers, I want you to really, really get that people have, as far as this planet is concerned,
absolutely,
it's all about people, okay? So we have to really then develop those strong connections with mm-hmm. the right people, okay? With the right people, those are those power connections and that's what we're going to be talking about. Now, networking on its as a tool to building and establishing those connections, you tell me about that.
Well, I actually equate the word networking with relationships. I think they are synonyms to each other.
Okay.
And I define networking as the art of building and sustaining mutually beneficial relationships before you need them. It's a whole process of making connections, following up, building and building and building so that a relationship that I'm here to help you, you're here to help me. And so that really, to me, that it boils all the way down to relationships, but it does take effort. It takes initiative to stay in touch with people.
Exactly. I think that I look at networking, absolutely agree with you, and I look at networking, you know, just to add to what you said, as the first step in establishing the relationship, okay? Because then you're talking about where do you make the connection? Where do you even establish it? Where do you even meet the people, you know? So it is networking. Is there the place where you do establish that number one step of contact, of making that connection, of making that, establishing that mm-hmm. relationship? And then the process then of building it is another matter.
Absolutely.
You know, building it and sustaining it mm-hmm. is now another matter. But networking is that place of where it really, really, really starts. And, you know, networking is not just something that's valuable in terms of, you know, we're talking about mutually beneficial relationships. When most people think about it, they think about it primarily in the context of business, professionally, to get ahead. But it also can impact our personal lives, our love lives.
Absolutely.
Okay, and you know, this is the month of love, and I thought, how cool is that, that Kathy, you know, has a very interesting dedication here in her book. When I was reading it, you know, she nicely autographed it, and then I was reading it recently, and she said to Brian, right?
She's Byron.
Byron. Sorry, I beg your pardon, Byron. From blind date to loving husband, you are my favorite networking success story. I thought, how cool is that? I've never heard that story, and I'm looking forward to hearing it today.
Awesome.
Which I hope you'll share with us. But, you know, just know that networking is not just about, you know, for career advancement. It is something that could really literally affect your life.
The rest of your life.
The rest of your life forever and ever.
A key relationship. Would you like to hear that story?
Exactly. I'd like you to share with viewers.
Well,
excellent. You know, tell us about that.
Okay. Well, the good news is we've been married 16 years now.
Oh, so
it's
wow.
A relationship that has grown and lasted, and he's a fantastic parent and father and partner to me.
Yes.
But we met through other people. In fact, we met on a blind date. I was introduced to him through some girlfriends that I
yes.
had gone on a weekend with, and they knew him and they knew me, and they saw the connection.
Yes.
Now, not too many people like to be fixed up, you know? But we were both open to meeting new people without any expectations.
Yes.
I'm not looking for the one. That never worked
exactly.
out for me. So we just went, and we went and had a first date, and there was some synergy that went on, and then we had a second date and third date. And this was somewhat interesting. Things started to become obvious to us that we were well matched.
Yes.
In fact, I will tell you, we are complete opposites, which is probably why we're well matched.
So well matched. Yes.
And then about 6 months later, I got a job offer to move to England.
Oh.
An incredible career opportunity. But here we had a dilemma. Here
yes.
was potentially the man that was going to be very significant in my life
yes.
and the ultimate career opportunity. And so we had to make a decision.
Yes.
And I ended up using another resource and tool. I had just taken a decision-making workshop. You know, those things you do at work to develop yourself professionally. And I thought, well, this is a decision. I literally pulled the binder off the shelf. I opened it up, and we went through this exercise. And we realized at the end of the exercise that we both had the same values and that we both wanted to design our life in the same way.
Yes.
So we elected to move to Europe together. We got engaged.
Oh,
and
wow.
6 months later, we got married.
Oh, how cute.
It's very romantic.
Very romantic. I mean, you've got it there. So really, what are the principles we get from this, your story? Number one, you were networked with your friends, certain friends, you know. So that's the people connection.
Absolutely.
The people connection gave you a referral, that's what we'll call it.
A referral?
They gave you a referral to Byron, and the rest is history.
Right.
You see, and that's how it works, networking,
yeah.
because I can attest to the fact that some of my closest friends
mm-hmm.
that have now become my closest friends, I met them at networking meetings.
Right.
You know, I mean, it's amazing how even professionally you and I have, you know, grown and all of that, just from knowing each other from, you know, a professional network.
Mm-hmm.
So it is something that can literally, literally impact the rest of your life.
Right.
Networking is not just for business, but for love. It's just the art of going out and establishing and building mutually beneficial relationships before you need them. It's just enhancing or growing your people connections, your people network.
And I knew also, I didn't go to meet him thinking again that we were going to be married.
Yes.
So I wasn't looking to transact with him.
Exactly.
I was looking to meet someone new and have a nice time and, you know, he could be a friend.
Exactly.
So being open to possibilities.
Exactly. So it's just about really knowing and understanding the value of people so
right.
that you're open to building relationships and
Absolutely.
Meeting more people, you know. And I mean, how cool is that? So, How cool is that? So, you know, networking is absolutely, absolutely, absolutely very, very important. People now are with the economy, you know, job seekers, people in transition, entrepreneurs, you know, they're coming now, you know, the big buzzword now is get out there and start networking and start networking and so on and so forth. But what would you then consider, you know, you have really expounded some phenomenal principles in this book. You use the analogy of a car, right, of driving an automobile in your book, which I so love. But what would you say is the foundational number one principle that people really, really need to get to be successful in networking?
It is be prepared. Be ready to drive. Have a strategy in mind so that when you are meeting with people, Princess Bola, that it can just be a nice time, it can just be a conversation, or you can have some intention to it. You can say to yourself, how could this person help me? How could I help this person?
Yes.
How do I want to position myself so this person understands what I'm all about? And so there's a little bit of preparation. Who do I want to meet with? Who do I want to spend my time with?
Exactly.
So there's some strategy, some preparation that when set in place can just make your networking activity that much more successful.
There's an adage that, you know, they provide in my culture, you know, they say preparation prevents poor performance. Or they would say prayerful preparation prevents poor performance. Mm-hmm. So basically, you know, if you want to get the results and be successful at it, you know, your preparation has to be a very, very, very good. You know, and that's one thing that I've observed from people, you know, in the community when they're networking. I observe that many people do not come prepared. Mm-hmm. You know, they don't know that every opportunity is a networking opportunity. Seizing those opportunities. So you meet someone, for example, I meet someone, you know, that I think is interesting, and I ask for their business card.
Mm-hmm.
And they'll be like, oh, I'm sorry, I ran away. Where is it? I left it at home.
Right.
You know, and I'm thinking to myself, you're coming to an event like this, and you're not prepared.
Right, so you bring your business card. This is like your credit card. Don't leave home without it, you know, always, everywhere.
Exactly, you know, so prepare, prepare, prepare. Mm-hmm. Understand that your success, the outcome, will depend on your preparation. So it's preparing not only, you know, yourself, you know, emotionally and mentally, and, you know, centering your mind and knowing that, you know, this is a place I'm going. Mm-hmm. I have been intentional, been strategic, that I'm going to so-and-so to achieve, not like you were saying, not to get something, but to build something, to establish relationships with people, because I value people. Mm-hmm. So having been prepared, and also just also being prepared physically, you know, the whole image, you know, your whole image and all of that would, and how you feel about yourself will also, you know, be so obvious. So you will communicate that in your body language.
Just,
and how
just the other day,
that.
I had to dash out to run a few errands. And
yes.
I figured I would actually be in the car, post office, bank, swing by the library. But I knew that I needed to go inside the library. And I looked at myself, and I was in sweatpants. I was very comfortably dressed.
Yes.
And I actually made the conscious decision to be prepared to change.
Yes.
Because I might meet somebody, and I might want to make a connection with someone new or someone that I know, and I didn't want to go sloppy.
Exactly.
So physically just changing and being dressed for success is one of the principles of preparation.
Absolutely, absolutely. And when you were reading your book, you know, using that analogy of driving a car is, you know, how can you, you know, drive a car if you've never learned, you know, how to drive? You don't know about driving. You've not prepared yourself. You didn't go to driving school. You know, you don't have a license. You're not going to go anywhere, you know.
Can I tell you a funny part of the book?
Yes.
I have a chapter called Door Dings and Road Grind.
Mm-hmm.
And how first impressions and last impressions in networking count. So I told a story, a real story, where I had met Jack Mitchell, the author of Hug Your People and Hug Your Customers. He is a CEO of a huge, very upscale men's and women's clothier retail chain, Selected Boutiques in Connecticut and California. And he invited me down to his store. Of course, I was very worried about what I was going to wear because I'm walking into a very expensive boutique.
Yeah.
But it didn't occur to me to really even clean my car. He's not going to see my car. I'm just going to drive and park. Well, the man offered to walk me to the car. and to take a big box that he was going to give me, I had to open my trunk in front of him. I didn't know if there were dry cleaning bags, you know, garbage. There could have been a dead body in there. I don't know. I was mortified, but I just had to carry it. Yet, but it was such a lesson.
Yes.
The car was green. It looked gray. It was dirty, filthy. And I had to show him that.
Yes,
and
yes.
And so I wasn't really prepared.
We were prepared.
I wasn't prepared.
And the preparation now, you even got to speak now, you know, it's just not even yourself now. It extends to how you'd get there, your transportation,
absolutely,
getting there. It's so many other little things that people don't even pay attention to. So that is really huge. It is understanding that your success, the foundation mm-hmm. to success in networking, is being prepared.
Mm-hmm.
You know, being prepared also means researching where you're going. Researching where you're going.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, because I used to not do that as well. You know, because then when you don't know where you're going and who you're expecting to meet there, who is going to be there, you know, you're also not prepared for those opportunities that will come when it's the person you really want to meet at that time. So, you know, preparing, researching where you're going, preparing yourself physically, preparing yourself mentally, preparing by having your business cards and all of that is the foundation to success. And now, you know, I've observed, you know, one of the things that I've observed from people networking, from my mm-hmm. clients that I'm trying to educate and all that is that the spirit with which people also network needs to shift. It needs to change. You know, most people are networking, going there, almost you can see their desperation.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, I want to meet somebody. I need a job. I want to meet the CEO of so-and-so place. Or do you know so-and-so and so? You know, I want to meet someone who knows someone who can get me a job or refer
me. You take my resume.
And take my resume, take my card. Or, you know, it's about me, and what I can get.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, that's a major mind shift that mm-hmm. I have told client after client that needs to change. You know, you have to shift your mind and realize that networking is not about what me and what I can get. And you touched on that in your book when you talk about the spirit of networking. It's more about what you can give, you know, what you can give. I want you to talk more about that because now we're talking about love and we're talking about something, you know, I developed something like, you know, the care,
mm-hmm.
care
mm-hmm.
Networking strategy, showing care at work and all of that. You know, so how important is that? I want you to speak to that. How
mm-hmm.
important is it to get to the spirit of networking and get the right spirit of networking so that you could be successful mm-hmm. at it?
Well, first, let me just ground us in at least the way I think about networking.
Yes.
That if you approach it from a transactional mindset,
yes.
will you buy this from me? Will you
yes.
take my resume? Will you hire me? Will you
yes.
give me something? You are shortchanging the value of that relationship. So
yes.
I like to say, you know, don't think transactions. Think relationships.
Mm.
Go for the long haul. Build the human people connection first
exactly.
before that ASCII stuff happens.
Exactly.
So I often chant that to myself.
Yes, yes.
You know, it's about the relationship. That's,
exactly.
that's what I'm doing.
And just to add to that is that, you know, your people, even when the relationship is established, the transactions will follow.
Absolutely. They're
because
happy to help you.
Because people do business with those they know, like, and trust.
Right.
Okay, so you have to build the relationship first. And once that is there, they know you, you like you, you have a solid, more solid relationship.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, they will do it with joy.
Absolutely.
They will do it with joy.
So maybe it's more about suspending the urge to transact until a relationship is developed.
Exactly. And so now what in building that relationship,
mm-hmm.
what is the spirit? So you're going
mm-hmm.
with that spirit.
Mm-hmm.
You're going with the spirit to give,
mm-hmm.
to build, to establish a relationship,
mm-hmm.
okay, not to transact.
Right.
I really like that, okay? That's a great tip for you, okay? Not transaction. Don't think transaction. Think relationships.
Right.
However, when you are now trying to build a relationship, there are two key principles
mm-hmm.
that are important there, you know,
mm-hmm.
in terms of, you were talking about the golden rule, and that's what, you know, why I really like this,
okay.
Doing this topic this month, because it's the month of love, you know. How does that impact? How does showing care, showing love, what
mm-hmm.
are those, how do those principles, will that impact
I have a chapter
success.
In the book called Rules of the Road, which
okay.
is really embracing the spirit of networking, which in my book is helping others,
yes,
and asking for help.
Yes, and that you can find that on page 28, by the way. And you know, Kathy has been so gracious. I have to tell this to you, my viewers, that Kathy has been so gracious this month to offer Friends of Princess Bola, which you are, a $3 off the cover price of this book, this phenomenal book. You know that I only deal with the brightest and the best, right? And I endorse this book, you know, my name is there on it. I read through the manuscript like Kathy was sharing in the beginning, and just a phenomenal, phenomenal book, you know, and coming from the queen of networking, you can take that as truth. So take advantage of that.
We have a promotion code too.
Yes.
Royalty.
Oh, okay,
so
exactly.
In Princess Bola's honor, it's, yes, royalty will get you that $3 off.
Okay, great, awesome. Great, thank you.
But back to the rules of the road. The,
yes,
spirit is helping others and asking for help.
Mm-hmm.
And I think helping others, first fueling that pump, getting it going, really putting yourself out there to be of service to others is a great way to build equity in those relationships. But you also need to make yourself vulnerable and ask other people, what am I looking for? What do I need? Can you help me with this? Do you know that person? So I find a lot of people, and I will say mostly women,
yes,
who are really good at just helping others. They're almost,
yes,
the good Samaritans,
exactly,
of networking, which is beautiful, but they end up feeling shortchanged because,
yes,
no one's helping them. And I say, well, whose fault is that?
Yes.
You're not asking.
Exactly.
So you must know, maybe this is back to preparation.
Yes.
Where do you need the help? What do you need the help with? Who do you need to connect with? And be brave enough to say to the people who care about you,
yes,
I'm working on this new project and I could really use some feedback, some connection, a referral. Can you take a look at this?
Absolutely. You know, and not just being brave, being humble.
Humble.
Because sometimes it's that big pride thing that's going on there,
okay,
you know,
yeah,
where we, you know, where we just feel, you know, I, mm-hmm, think sometimes it's pride that's also there. It's not so much sometimes people don't have the courage, but the pride factor. But, you know, yes, going back to talking about the spirit of mm-hmm, the networking, mm-hmm, thing and the golden rule and being the month of love, you know, it's all, we have to realize that the best way and the best strategy in terms of motivating people and building successful relationship is love. Okay, and love is not this romantic word that only, you know, that people have come to associate it with. It's not lust, it's not this romantic thing. Love is just the golden rule. Having respect for people, you know, liking people, being patient, being courteous, you know, really just caring, you know, really do caring, which is mm-hmm. how I came about, you know, the CARE networking strategy, you know, system, you know. And CARE stands for celebrate, applaud, refresh, and equip. So when you're networking with people, you celebrate them.
Absolutely.
You know, you celebrate them. You celebrate who they are, their accomplishments, who they are as people. You just celebrate people, you know, and people can respond to that.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone can resonate with that. Celebrate, applaud them, you know. Applaud them for anything they've achieved, have accomplished. Applaud them just as humans, you know. It takes a lot, if they're entrepreneurs, it takes a lot of guts and courage to be an entrepreneur.
Absolutely.
You know. And so applaud them. And then the refreshing is, you know, how do you refresh them? How can you, like you said, how can I be a blessing to you? How can I assist you? How can I help you? What is there any way in which I could serve you
mm-hmm.
and it helps you, make you better, or help you to achieve?
Energize you.
You know, yeah, your
renew
goals.
You. Mm-hmm.
Do I know of any resources? I may not be able to do it
mm-hmm.
personally. But I may be able to refer you to resources that I know about. I know of this great book. I know of this seminar. I know, you know, of this person, you know. So that's the refreshing piece of that management networking system that I've created. And then the one is equip, is the empowering you, you know. And how do I empower you? How can I equip you for success, for greater mm-hmm. success? To get you from A to Z. So when we adopt that strategy,
mm-hmm.
you know, when our mind shifts and that is what it's about, you know, we become more successful because there's no one who doesn't like to feel appreciated,
mm-hmm.
respected, loved, and celebrated, you know.
And so, this is how easy that is. This morning, I took a magazine that I was reading last night,
yes.
And I was reading actually an advertorial on the business of giving, companies that are doing philanthropic things around the world.
Yes.
And two women in my network popped into my mind.
Mm.
Now, I could just let that come and go, and isn't that nice? But I
yes.
actually took the effort to take the article, I made two copies, and I mailed it to each one of them. I thought you'd be interested in this. This could be a good connection for you.
Yes.
Now, whether they choose to act on it or not is their business.
Exactly.
But they know that I'm thinking about them,
exactly.
that I'm trying to put them in place and in touch. I care about their success.
Yes.
So with little acts like that, even if we don't sit down together for coffee,
yes.
that is caring for people in your network.
Exactly. And I know you're also an independent send out card
distributor. Mm-hmm.
And exactly, and I recently,
awesome.
Yes,
great.
Because I so believe in it, and I think this kind of really ties in with the whole care networking strategy or system, you know, that I've created, and as well as some of the rules that you have so well expounded in your book in terms of the spirit of networking and some of the rules and principles you shared here. So people really need to get a hold of this. I'm yet to put mine in book form.
I can't wait to get it.
And so, you know, someone else who has done a phenomenal job of it. And so I really, really recommend getting a hold of this book. But, you know, I also have read the founder of Send Out Cards, Cody
Bateman.
Bateman's book,
Promptings.
You know, Promptings.
Very good.
You
book.
Know, and very absolutely. And he talks about those little acts of kindness and all of that. How, you know, can a system like that, so easy to use, mm-hmm. how can that help people in their networking, in their networking strategy and success?
Well, what Send Out Cards is, as you know, is an online greeting card and gifting system
yes.
that allows you to jump on a computer anywhere on the internet and pick a card, type a personal message, and send it. And
yes.
then they do all the work. They
exactly.
print it, they put in an envelope, they put a stamp on it,
mm.
and they send it through the old-fashioned mailbox.
Exactly.
And then the person walks out to the mailbox expecting bills and direct mail, and there it is, your personal greeting card that
customized.
Says, I care
yes.
about you, I was thinking about you, and it lifts their day.
Yes,
so
yes.
It's just a remarkable. I've been using it for 5 years now. I think I've sent 7,000 cards.
Wow,
I'm a crazy busy user. But it allows me to stay in touch and to keep that relationship going.
Exactly. And which is the next thing we're going to be talking about,
okay.
keeping the relationship going. But before we go to keeping the relationship going, do you think that some people, personality types, put it that way, are more naturally inclined to be better networkers than others,
okay.
you know, because how does that impact, you know, a networking success? Some people, you know, you refer to as the reluctant networker,
reluctant
you know.
Networker, right.
Some people are just people shy. They feel they're not naturally, people persons,
right.
you know. They don't think so much of their people skills.
Yes.
And, you know, they know the value. They
mm-hmm.
do. Have coming to know the value of networking and all of that, and they want to do it.
It's just
but
hard.
So it's just hard for
right,
them.
Right.
So what kind of tips will you give to the reluctant
right.
networker? I know you're doing a workshop on
yes.
that soon.
Networking ahead for the reluctant networker.
Exactly.
Sensory Library,
very
February
lively.
16th.
Yes.
So you've got your extroverted people, and
yes.
you have your introverted or introspective people.
Yes.
And then there's some in between.
Yes.
But the difference is how these two kinds of personality types re-energize themselves.
Mm.
One's not good or bad. It's just when I need to lift myself up, do I do it with lots of people,
yes.
like the extrovert, or do I do it by myself or with just one or two people in
yes.
a more quiet way?
Yes.
And so for the introspective introvert, networking at a convention or large meeting is exhausting.
Yes.
It wears them out, so they tend to avoid it.
Yes.
Now, the good news is networking can be done and should be done, I think, one-on-one. So here's a tip for an introverted person that maybe you don't go, even though I do encourage you to go to the events, But maybe you do it more one-on-one. Maybe you're sitting down and having coffee and lunch one person at a time, and you're building those one-on-one relationships so that you can maintain your energy.
Yes.
You're still going to need to get yourself to those large events,
exactly,
because that's Total Women's Conference opportunity.
Exactly.
So if you go to that large event, maybe you allow yourself time to take a five-minute break, to get some fresh air, to rejuvenate yourself so you can go back at it.
Absolutely.
So it is about energy management.
Okay, absolutely. And so you've got it. So if you are that reluctant networker, or the networker, you know, personality, with a different kind of maybe personality, you know, who is, you know, networking shy, but you know the value now, you know it's important for you to do it. You know you have to get out there, really get out of your comfort zone and get out there and go to places where people are. If you want to meet people, you have to go where people congregate.
Absolutely.
You know, so if you want to meet business people, you have to go to business meetings and business events. If it's more personal, you want to do it, you know, personally. Social media is also a great tool these days of networking and meeting people. But after doing the establishing the network, the relationship, then the building of it has to happen at some point face-to-face. There has to be some face-to-face. And so, you know, that's a great tip that Kathy has really kind of shared. You know, knowing yourself and knowing how to manage your energy. You know, being self-aware, self-conscious, and knowing how to manage that is the number one way that you, as a reluctant networker, can really be successful at it. So when you do go to the event, taking periodic breaks, you know, going to recapture your energy and all of that is a great tool and a great
tip. Can I give you another tip?
Yes.
This is one of my favorite ones. And I will tell you that even though I am an extroverted personality type, I still get a little bit of a heart increase. I get some sweaty palms. I get nervous going to big events. And I have to coach myself into it. Come on, Kathy, we're going to go talk to strangers. Go get a girl. I got to cheerlead myself in. But when I give myself a job, like I sometimes play a little game that I'm going to pretend like I'm the host of the party. And how would I behave if I was the host? Would I hide in the corner, look at the artwork? Would I look down at the carpet? Would I talk to only one person? No way. That would be rude as a host. So I welcome people. I have taken people's coats. I have shown them the, you know, I've guided them into the room. I have introduced them to other people, and then I go back and do it again.
Yes.
Now I've got a job, and I feel important and valuable.
Yes, that's a great.
And it makes other people.
Exactly. That's a great tip.
Yeah, be the host.
And a mind, be the host, and a mind shift as well, you know, in terms of, okay, I'm going there to be the host, you know, that is a really great one, and a really great tip. And then in terms of I look at how we're talking about, you know, showing love, showing care, the golden rule. And I do a lot of personal coaching, as you know. And a lot of my clients, you know, the issues that they have going on that are the roadblocks to success, you know, at work or even in their personal life, has more to do with them, have more to do with their own sense of value, their own sense of esteem, their own, you know, sense of value and esteem, whereby, you know, you don't love yourself enough, you don't care for yourself enough to invest in yourself, to invest in yourself, in getting a hold of a tool, a book that you know will be valuable to you, taking time for yourself to attend the Total Woman Conference, even though it's on a Saturday, April 2nd, you know. And that's more of what they're not feeling worthy and all of that. And then that obviously is going to impact their own success at networking. Because like we are saying, the body language, the whole thing, the sweaty arms, palms and everything.
The eye contact. Everything. Voice.
Voice. All of that is going to really impact that. And how is that going to affect the person they're trying to reach? What is that saying to the individual they're trying to make the connection with?
It all communicates, and it communicates weakness, desperation. It is completely transparent that you don't think highly of yourself when you go in that state. And it puts the other person in an odd position.
Yes.
It's also not great energy to be around. And they may not want to extend their network to you, because if you go in that state, it's a bad reflection on them.
Exactly.
I remember once I had a gentleman who called me on the phone, and just based on the conversation, his tone of voice, he was asking for me to have coffee with him. Now, I agreed, but his voice told me that he wasn't worth spending time with, that he didn't even think he was worth spending time with. He ended up having to cancel on me that morning of, and I did not reschedule because energetically he wasn't in the right state.
Exactly, exactly.
I don't know if he knew that he was pushing that energy out.
Yes, they probably don't know.
Right.
You probably don't know. They're probably not aware of it. And that's why I want to suggest to you this month of love, you know, let that love begin with you. Let it begin with you, you know, self-love, self-care, you know, and take and tell yourself, I'm worthy, I'm worth it. You know, I'm worthy of the taking the time for myself. I'm worthy to invest $100 or $20 in this book. I'm worthy to sign up for that conference and take time for me, you know. So because when you start making that, being intentional about caring for you, about loving you, you know, you're really building up your own sense of value and your own esteem, and you will communicate that to others, and you'll be able to extend that to other people. Mm-hmm. And I think that is really, 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 you know, very important, you know, when we're talking about, like you're saying, that sometimes women are the ones who are impacted by this the most, because we're such nurturers, we're such givers, you know, we like to be martyrs, more or less, and give our lives for everybody else, but not knowing how to receive.
Right.
Not knowing how to receive and not knowing how to celebrate ourselves and applaud ourselves and, you know, like you were saying, talk to ourselves and coach ourselves.
Absolutely.
And encourage ourselves and get ourselves going.
Walk into
out there.
Your greatness.
Exactly, exactly. So that's so, so important, you know, and it's something that... you know, that, you know, I really want viewers to really take away this month, especially being the month of love, for you to learn that.
Can I add to that?
Yes.
I just wrote an article about networking and coming from a place of strength, which I think ties into what you're talking about.
Yes.
And how you have to get yourself in the right state of mind, body, and spirit to be successful in networking. And I wrote it because someone had sent me a comment and a question about the desperate job seeker.
Yes.
And I so feel for them because these in transition periods are lasting months, years.
Yes.
You know, it's tough to be out of work for 2 years.
Exactly.
And it's a slippery slope. So I think some of the best things that they can do, which I share in my article, is about taking care of self, exercising, getting good food, hanging around with positive people, investing in yourself, finding that mindful part of you. All will help you not only overcome that circumstance, but be able to network effectively and feel better about yourself because you're taking care of yourself.
Exactly,
so
exactly. It is absolutely so important. So, you know, and also being taking deliberate steps, you know, and having an action plan, you know, the things that would make you feel that you are actually caring for yourself, you know. So it's not just saying, okay, I'm going to do it. I'm going to care for myself. I do love myself. But what are the tangible things that you do to evidence that, to show that, yes. And, you know, like for me, like I was saying, you know, not wanting to overflog that is investing yourself. Because sometimes I find people like that, you know, oh, Saturday I can't come. Or, oh, this book I can't afford it. I said, you cannot afford not to come.
Absolutely.
Not to, you know, because it's more than the event. It's more about you, what you're telling me about you, who you are and how you value yourself. You know, and we're not saying you should be, it's finding a balance. You should be self-absorbed, you know, and family is important and your children is important, but it's just creating that space for your own self to input your own self so that you have much more to output and to give to others, which is what networking is about. You have greater value and greater to offer people. You know, but I want us to speak to some career professionals because you and I, you're a solopreneur, so am I, you know, and I think most of the people who are getting it this networking, how important networking is. You know, they are usually solopreneurs or people who are looking for work in transition and all of that. And, you know, they just kind of do it out more out of desperation. They feel, you know, I don't have
it.
A choice. I need it. They need to. I don't have a choice. I must, you know. So, and that's what they also tell them, you know, job coaches tell them, you know, network, network, network. So, okay, so their mindset is shifting. But then we have the career professional.
They've got a job. Everything's okay.
Everything is okay. And, you know, they finally land their dream job after transitioning and so on and so forth. And then they adopt this, what I call... cubicle mentality, you know,
right.
Where they just stay in their
all
little
the
cubicle, all the projects, all the time, you know, take lunch one, you know, now and again, and go to the cafeteria, if there's one, and spend 10 minutes and zoom out, and all of that, not really making any effort to, you know, network, you know, they feel they don't need it.
They abandon their people bridges, don't
Exactly, exactly. And then, you know, what would you say to that person?
Well, to me, networking is not an event or an activity. It is a strategy for life, for a successful life. And absolutely, it's a strategy, a core strategy for successful career management.
Mm-hmm.
So if you have a job, I will tell you, you're in the best position to network.
Yes.
Why? Because you have lots of resources. You have people that you could connect with. You need to be networking inside your company, between divisions, but absolutely outside the company. One of the travesties of people who end up, you know, they're in transition, then they get a job, which is fabulous. They go missing in action. They don't even let people know where they landed. You don't hear from them. You don't know how to contact them. They resurface 3 years later when they're looking for work
again.
And then the rest of us are going, where have you been?
Yes, yes.
I know they're busy. I know they've got a lot of demands on the job, but they've got to carve out time to maintain those people bridges, to maintain their network.
Absolutely, so, absolutely. It is so, so, so crucial. You know, I like the way that you put it. So you put it so eloquently. It is not an event. It is a lifestyle, you know. It is a strategy for life. It is a lifestyle, you know, just understanding that. And wherever you are, whatever place, whether you're a career professional, in job, out of job, without job, whatever, just realizing and understanding that this is the first step towards building relationship with people, establishing your people bridge, your people power, your power connections. Without those bridges, you cannot go from A to B.
And we know bridges need maintenance, don't they?
Exactly. And we don't burn bridges either. We don't burn bridges either.
No, we don't burn bridges.
We don't bridges either. So, you know, they need maintenance and we don't burn them. We don't just build them and think, okay, I've used you to climb to A. I'm now at B. And so really, at this point, I don't need you anymore. And you burn that bridge. What happens when you need to go back to the other side?
Right.
Or get to another, you know. So we don't do that. So it's important for every one of us, regardless. And we've learned from your story that it's not just a valuable strategy for going networking ahead for business, but we can now put
career,
in brackets,
right.
In parentheses, for love.
For love. I love it.
Yeah, for love, because, you know, you're only as powerful as your people network. You're only as successful as your network. Everything is about connections and about people and all of that. You're only as influential and successful. Exactly. As your people. So how huge is your people network, and how diversified is it also? That's another topic for another day, you know, in terms of how diversified is it, you know, and also what kind of people make up your network, you know. So that is really important questions for you to really kind of think about as you're watching this show and as you're reading Kathy's book, you know, is how diversified is my people network? How large is it, you know? And what kind of people make up that network, you know? Because if you're surrounded by not the right kind of people, and you're really not going anywhere, show me who they are, and I'll tell you how far you can go and all that, or not go.
I think one of the most interesting, you know, questions of makeup or opportunity is for younger professionals to be networking with older professionals and older professionals to be networking with younger professionals.
Yes.
We are almost from a different world, a different planet sometimes, and we communicate differently. But there's so much value that I personally gained when I reach out to college students, college graduates, even high school students, and I invite them into my network. I learn a lot from them.
Absolutely.
And I can also teach them.
Yes.
You know, and so that's across generations.
Exactly. So that's the diversity. It's across generational lines, ethnocultural lines, you know, denominational lines, whatever lines they are, you know, you just need to have that network and have that diversity in your network.
And I will say, I realize that in a very keen way at your Total Women's Conference last year, which actually I attended. It was the day before I wrote the final chapter. And so you influenced my final chapter.
Thank you.
And it was astounding how many different faiths and nationalities and ages, women from all walks of life, and how enriching that was.
Yeah, thank you.
It was
I know that is something I'm very passionate about and I'm intentional about.
Good.
I am intentional about it because, you know, I believe in diversity. You know, it has to be diverse. It has to be large, your network, because, you know, everybody has value and different value that they bring and all of that. So the more diversified it is, the better.
It's like a portfolio, isn't it?
Exactly.
A financial portfolio.
Exactly. That's how I put it. Actually, I have one of my workshops is called How Diversified Is Your People Portfolio?
Nice,
you know,
nice.
That's the title. So it is a portfolio and we have to begin to see it like that. Mm-hmm. And yes, so I'm very intentional in my networking and at my events to make sure that it's across all those lines. Mm-hmm. And I also do it across socioeconomic lines.
Absolutely.
Okay, you'll find me at the shelter at the end of the year, you know, Christmas, Operation Joy to the World, going to the homeless community. And, you know, you see me on Park Street and everybody be like, hi, Princess Paula. You know, regardless of your social strata, you know. And then I have the high-profile executives, senior C-level executives as well in my network. So it really is important. Now, we want to begin to wrap up because we only have a few minutes left. And I want to give you a recap, really, very, really a great honor of having Kathy McAfee, America's Marketing Motivator, author of Networking Ahead for Business. And I'm adding this month for love. If you want to know why I added for love, you'd read her dedication in her book, which she shared her story about meeting how she met her husband, her best networking success story. And so, you know, Kathy has been sharing, you know, just some wonderful tips and rules and strategies for networking. And she's going to be a featured presenter. She's going to be facilitating a networking segment at the Total Woman Conference on April 2nd. April 2nd, 2011, at the Simsbury Inn. I listened to my guests. I listened to them. They said they didn't want the expo setting. It was too large. It lost its intimacy. And so this year, it's going to be at the Simsbury Inn. It's a 5-star hotel, very intimate, very classic, very nice, on April 2nd. So network and get ready for that. Get ready to network, to meet a diversity of women across all kinds of, you know, ethnic, social, and you know, lines. And so as we want to begin to wrap up the broadcast today, and tell me how once they have networked, which is they've established the contact, they've met the individual, they have them in their network, in their database, they've made that connection, whether, you know, it's via Facebook, whichever way they establish it, or whether it's live, tell me the importance of following up. Because, you know, here are many people, stacks of business cards. You see them once, you met them, they give you their word, I'll be in touch, and voila, nothing again.
Right.
Tell me about that.
Well, you know, Woody Allen said that 80% of winning was just showing up.
Yes.
In networking terms, that's making the connection.
Exactly.
What's the balance, the 20% of success?
Yes.
It's following up. So you really, really, really must have a systematic approach to following up, an organized, structured way. Otherwise, we're all busy, we're lazy, we're disorganized. So I've had to put in place for me a way of tracking all my contacts, mm-hmm. of reaching out to those contacts, mm-hmm. of making it a weekly priority, because that's where the relationship shifts.
Exactly.
Because you're investing in it. You're investing in that person and that relationship over time.
Yes.
I've had people that, in fact, I talk about my first boyfriend in the book and how what he taught me about receiving gracefully. I am still in touch with him. He's still in my network. That was a million years ago. I have people that I, again, had my first jobs with, I'm still in touch with. And it does take effort. So that follow-up is what carries that relationship forward.
Absolutely.
So it's
absolutely.
vital.
And it's having a system. The system is the important part. You know, having that system in place where you have your contacts categorized, having a system like send out cards, which is just so huge.
Allows you, to act on it.
Exactly. If you go to Kathy's website, marketingmotivator.net, and if you go to my website, royalproclamations.net, that's a very valuable system where you can learn about it. Mm-hmm. You can sign up for it, for it, learn more about it there. It's a great system to have in place whereby you're sending out cards once a week or once a month, you know, mm-hmm. just to touch base. I'm thinking about you, an inspirational card, and I've received so many from you, you know, and all of that. So having that system whereby you're following up and then you're also keeping in contact, keeping in touch mm-hmm. With your network is so huge.
And so many ways you can do that. You can certainly do it through social media, LinkedIn, Facebook, Twitter. You could call people the old-fashioned way. I love to do that.
Yes.
Even if I get a voicemail, you still know I care about you.
Yes.
We could spend the time to get together or go to events together.
Yes.
We could mail things together, sending cards and letters, send out cards and other means. So there's all sorts of ways we can stay in touch. We just need to actively do it.
Do it. Okay.
And usually, Princess Bull, I'll note that it's usually one person will take the lead. Okay. Not everyone is good with follow-up.
Yes.
I've noticed
exactly.
this.
Exactly. I know.
So this is an opportunity to really shine. If you step up to the plate and say, I'm going to be really proficient at following up.
Yes.
I'm going to carry this relationship into the future.
And the other thing, though, is that sometimes you have to also learn and know when the response, the silence, means that, you know, I don't really want to have a relationship with
appropriate levels of follow-up.
Exactly,
yes.
You know, and just knowing that, because sometimes, you know, it's not everybody that we want to mm-hmm. have a relationship with that wants to, you know, they for whatever reasons, mm-hmm. you know. And they may just think it's not worth it to them, you're not valuable enough, whatever, you know. Don't take it personally, by the way, you know.
Sometimes you need to back off on that gas pedal and be patient.
Exactly, and kind of read. And sometimes people are just, you know, very busy. They missed, you know, responding to you and all that. And it's not that they do not want to. So, but you have to be able to discern and know when, you know, and read the situation and read when that person is more or less saying, you know what, mm-hmm. no thank you. Mm-hmm. kind of thing. So that's important so that you don't get labeled as a stalker.
That's a bad thing.
We don't want that. But anyway, this is where we're going to really kind of just end today's show. It's just
so
it's been so very interesting. And I tell you, time flies. I can't believe it's 60 minutes already. Ooh. I mean, it's been a 60-minute special, you know, that I've been really sharing because I'm committed to your success. In 2011, I really want to take you from where you are to where you really want to be. And we're building those power bridges. And this month, we have built the people bridge, the connection bridge, so that you will get there. You need people. You need people. You've got the principles, but it's all been captured in this powerful book by Kathy. And it's called Networking Ahead for Business. This month, you get a special love offering. You get a special love offering and you get $3 off. Royalty is the promo code for that. Networkingahead.com. As well as this month as well is your opportunity, you know, now to put these things into practice. It's one thing for you to hear the whole thing, the whole story, and you know and have all the knowledge. It's another thing to put it into practice. Mm-hmm. And an opportunity, a great networking opportunity, as well as personal and professional development opportunity, awaits you at the Total Woman Conference, the third annual Total Woman Conference, mm-hmm. on Saturday, April 2nd, at the Simsbury Inn in Simsbury, Connecticut. And this month, a love offering from me, also $10 off the already unbelievable ticket price, honestly. So go to totalwomanconference.com. Let's continue the conversation. Awesome. You know, we continue via Facebook. I'm on Facebook. I'm on LinkedIn. I'm on Twitter. You know, and then on my own website, my new website, royalproclamations.com, I have a forum, you know, mm-hmm. that you can come in and we can chat and you can leave your, you know, and you can ask questions and post your own comments and give your own feedback and share your own networking experience and, you know, testimonial about Kathy's book and other things, you know. I mean, I would just really, really, really love to hear from you, you know. It's not a monologue. It's a conversation that we're having here. So please visit me on Facebook, on LinkedIn, on Twitter, and royalproclamations.com to continue this phenomenal conversation. And I want to say a big, 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 big thank you to you, Kathy. I am just so honored and so blessed to have you in my professional network. You are such an inspiration and you're such an encouragement and such a blessing. And I want to thank you for your time, for coming on Inspire Success today. Of course, I'm going to be seeing you very soon. And I hope to see you too very soon on April 2nd at the Total Woman Conference at the Simsbury Inn. This is Princess Bola Adelani, the Total Success Coach, reminding you to keep smiling. Hey, you know, life's too short. Put a smile on your face, okay? Keep believing. Keep learning. Keep networking. Keep on keeping on. I'll see you next month for another inspirational show. Take care. God bless. Bye-bye.